So, today I am Gianfilippo Munera. We to discuss a topic related to synchronous generators or alternators and in films we call the alternating current generators. And the topic that I will be discussing today is the Peutz triangle and the Peutz reactance. So to proceed, the Peutz triangle is used to determine the voltage regulation of synchronous generator or alternator. This method is also called Peutz method. The operation of an alternator, the armature resistance drop I sub RA and armature leakage reactance drop I sub XL are actually EMF quantities, while the armature reaction is basically MMF quantity. MMF is the electromotive force. Ayan, magnetomotive force quantity na i-discuss ng mga susunod na reporters. Kasi may ano, sa synchronous generators meron tayong different methods. One of the methods is ito nung i-discuss ko, the CPF method. Which is mag-discuss naman ng MMF method. Saka mayroon ding IEEE method. So, to give you a simpler explanation, ang ZPF method is nakabasis siya sa separation ng armature leakage reactance. Ngayon, tatanda natin yung pinaka-concept niya, separation of armature leakage reactance and reaction effects. So, basically, yung regulation din niya is nakadepende din sa separation of liquid reactants and liquid reactants of armature and their effects. Ganun talaga yung pinaka-concept niya. Separation siya. Kaya ito na nga pala nasa, yan, sa may pangalawang ano na. So, dun sa paliwanag ko na, the armature liquid reactants is also called feature reactants in this method. Extending. Hence, the ZPF method is also called Peutz reactance method. So, the Peutz triangle, in order to obtain the voltage regulation using Peutz's method, the armature leakage reactance is X sub L, with the EMF quantity, electromotive force quantity, and armature reaction effect, the magnetomotive quantity are determined separately by performing two tests on the alternator. First, the open circuit test and the zero power factor test. So, sa open circuit test, yung ginagawa na dito is pinapabayaan yung alternator na tumakbo sa synchronous speed given by the driver with the no load connected across the armature. Tapos may voltmeter naman na naka-connect dun sa armature open circuit line na nag-measure ng open circuit voltage. Tapos, doon natin makuha yung mga results from the open circuit test. So, sunod naman is the zero power factor test, in which I will be discussing today. So, sa zero power factor test is, naman tayo ditong graph para sa ma-illustrate at mas ma-different siyang basically. So ito yung the figure illustrated shows the saturation curve of terminal voltage against field excitation or the field current required to deliver full load short circuit armature current. So to determine the zero power factor test, first i-define muna natin yung mga points. Yung point A shows the field current corresponding to the zero terminal voltage. So, the line OB, or the line point O in B, tangent to the OCC, is called an air gap line. Ito, yung may mga broken lines. The point P one is obtained at rated terminal voltage, while the alternator delivering full load current at 3 PF lagging. So, ano, from C, point P, the PQ is drawn equal to point OA, and the line QR are parallel to air gap line which intersects OCC point R. Now, proceeding to the next step, zero power factor test. Magdodraw tayo ng line from point A parallel to point PR intersecting to OCC at point P. Tapos the triangles OAB and PQR are similar. So, sunod na gagawin natin is to draw the perpendiculars in triangles OAB and PQR from point B and R such that they meet at point C and point Q in the lines OA and PQ respectively. So, after all of that, we can now define the triangle PQR as the Peutz triangle na nag-remain constant for a given armature current. So, with that, pwede rin siya matransfer to other points like Q prime, Q, Q prime, R prime to obtain the triangle OAB sa pinakbaba, which is the ano, so may I, ano, IR. So yung peak in the triangle, yung peak PR, the line RS, again, presensya ng armature leakage drop, which is the IXL. You can see, and yun naman, may triangle na pinak, sa triangle na pangatlo, ayun o, IXL. So to ano, proceed. Meron tayong mga formulas na ginagamit to solve some problems involved with ano, zero power factor test. So, proceed tayo sa mga regulations. So, in accordance to the ano, figure kanina, meron siya na-develop na formula, which is ito. Yung kung ano, kung babasa kayo dun sa may ano, sa may graph, you can develop a formula which is the ano, leakage reactance equals to point RS or the point PC all over the armature current at full load. Pero kung ano, may mga givens tayo na voltage drop phase tsaka full load armature current, you can use this formula which is the ano, leakage reactance equal to voltage drop all over phase all over full load armature current. So last naman, since nakuha na natin to, para makuha natin yung voltage regulation, we will use the ano, full load EMF minus V all over V times 100. And that will be all. That concludes my discussion. Thank you for patiently listening. And God bless.